God has set before every one of you a blessing and a curse. How you choose to live your life, whether you obey the commandments of the Lord your God, or whether you will not obey the commandments of the Lord your God, but turn aside out of the way which He commanded us and go after other gods, you choose your own fate. Do you want to be cursed of God? Then reject His law. Ignore Him. Serve other gods. Don't obey the God of the Bible, and God will curse you. This is written to a nation that was beginning to prosper, beginning to grow, coming into a promise. Here you go. Here you're about to go into a promise, right, of blessing and prosperity. I believe America was started and founded on righteous principles. I believe that it was founded with the concept of religious liberty, the freedom to speak what you want to speak and say what you want to say and live how you want to live according to the Bible as the law, you know, the law that should rule the land. Now, since then, there's been a bunch of judges and amendments and things that try to change the law and subvert God's authority and give everybody authority, give your cat more rights than the human being, than your baby has, right? I mean, America is so messed up. America is so wicked before God, exceedingly wicked, more perhaps than Sodom and Gomorrah were. How strange, how wicked, how bad it's gotten where I mean, abortions are just funded internationally by America. That's disgusting. This country was founded to glorify God. This country was founded as a safe haven for Christians, for Bible believers, to raise up children. And listen, we need to get back to the principles of God, and we can preserve the next generation. Listen, if we go through a time of trouble as a church, as a nation, if God curses this nation, and God so chooses to put troops in our streets as a judgment to take away our liberty, and God decides to break the staff of bread and affect us with a pestilence and famine and wild beasts and the sword of war, if God chooses to do that to America, we would in no way say, God, we don't deserve that. We deserve better. Excuse me? Do you not know what's happening in other countries around the world? Are you clueless to what's going on in the Middle East by our hand? How wicked! Are you clueless to what's going on in South America? How there's whole nations that are without bread. There's children being raised. They don't even know how to read or write. All they know is they have to steal to eat that day. God has blessed America. And if we don't change something, God will curse America for our demise. But again, this is an opportunity for Christians. This is an opportunity for believers to show the strength of the Spirit of God, to stand strong in righteousness and not be overcome with fear and not be so overcome with those that serve other gods that we just give up and lose our righteousness and do the wrong thing and we don't stand up and speak the truth as we ought to.